Well, here we have the finished product. You've seen me cut the didgeridoo, scrape all the bark back, and here's the finished product, painted as well with the tamara on it. The didgeridoo is one of the world's oldest wind instruments. And what's so unique about the didgeridoo is that it doesn't have a reed, it doesn't have finger holes. It's up to you to do the sound, to produce the twangs with your tongue, with your lips, and do the sounds in your voice box. I can show you how to play the didgeridoo, but it's up to you to put the time and effort into practicing every day, 1 hour, 2 hours, to play it and so forth. Now, to play the didgeridoo, you've got to do a sharp raspberry. Don't blow like a trumpet because it's not a brass instrument, it's timber. This is what it sounds like. If you blow it hard like a trumpet, it sounds pretty terrible. Blow softly. Try and do some twangs also with your tongue. Now the voice box is there for its purpose also. You do sounds like the dingoes, kookaburras, mopokes, emus, and you can do sounds that are produced through the didgeridoo and the sound synthesized. Now the sound is also inside, you have all the little cracks and holes that the termites have left behind. That's what also synthesizes the sound. It doesn't sound very good at this end, but at that end, it sounds very good. So, for example, the dingo, that's the wild dog. They don't bark, they howl. You've got to do the sound in your voice box. Throw the voice, but vibrate it at the same time. To do a dingo, for example, do 5 short calls and 1 big long one. Dingo. Kookaburra. That's a laughing jackass. A bit faster. Takes practice. Mopoke. It's a bird that sits up in the tree, looks at you. Brolga, that's a large crane. Now, apart from the sounds that are done in your voice box, try and do some twang noises with your tongue. For example, kangaroo. If you imagine a kangaroo hopping in the road, it sounds like this. That's a big fella. Imagine a little joey trying to keep up with him. Some little things that you can experiment with. Now, apart from the sounds, we now get on to the next step, such as recycled breathing. That's the hard part. Now, didgeridoo players are famous for blowing down the didge and sucking air through the nose at the same time. There are different techniques you can use to practice this. My technique is to blow short little so I'm blowing short little bursts and sucking when I'm blowing out. Now don't try too much, don't try too hard, just relax. Once you've mastered that, do it a bit longer. Until you finally go. I'm storing air in my cheeks, but I'm also taking air down to my lungs. And later on, when you do fast and slow rhythms, you're using your diaphragm as well to keep the rhythm pumping. So keep practicing. Blow and breathe air through your nose and back out the nose. Okay? It's hard, but practice makes comes perfect. Now, the first step I showed you was just to blow it. Try now with the grunt sound as you blow it. Now try a twang, so you're doing three things. Now when you recycle breathe, you're doing four things. Watch this. Now the rhythm I'm doing there is probably a little bit too advanced. Just come back to something that's nice and slow and simple. Now, here are some different rhythms that you can probably play if you practice. You probably noticed that at some stage when I was blowing it, I was doing a little those to me are little cue calls. If I'm doing a show and I'm playing the didgeridoo, when the dancers are dancing, I do a little boop. That cues them to go on to the next step, go on to the next dance. Listen. Now, there's only so much I can show on how to play the didgeridoo in this situation. But if you practice your breathing, practice your blowing, maybe one day we can play some didgeridoo together.